think I have given you the option of unmuting and speaking.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Sachin. Where are you from, Sachin?
I think we are I'm from Latur, Maharashtra, sir.
Are we exchanging emails or WhatsApp or something like that? Because your name is familiar to me.
Yes, sir. I'm from. I chat with WhatsApp only.
Ah, you have chatted with me WhatsApp. Right.
Yes.
Okay. So yesterday you were there.
No, I missed the class, but I yesterday pinged you through Messenger.
Huh.
I got the YouTube link and I have seen that one.
You have seen that one. Okay. How did you like that session?
Yes, I like that session.
You like the session?
Okay. Yes.
So you are into real estate?
Yes, I am a real estate broker. Hmm. And I am that in one that 85% of people fail.
Hmm,
first of all,
you are in that category. Okay.
I am in that category only. Yes, sir.
Thomas, good morning. Say, you can unmute and speak, Thomas. You are from Kochi. Very nice to see that Kochi people also are there. Okay. Thomas, I think you need to probably rename your mobile, because in the mobile it is coming as 584.169.E1. There is also one more Moto G8 Power Lite. So what, Thomas, are you able to unmute and speak?
Cubic part. So RAM is equal to RAM plus within jacket.
Moto G is giving some session, I think, to somebody. Sandeep Bhargava. So 584.169.E1 to everyone. This is the first time you are using. Thomas, is it? Thomas, you are using for the first time? Is that Thomas? Okay, don't worry, I'll change your name. Okay. You need to now become digital. There's no other choice. You have to learn, Thomas. So I have renamed you. Okay, I have renamed you as Thomas. Thomas from Kochi. There is 5570C, CA46.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, Mr.
Hi, this is Shubhanandi from Calcutta. Yesterday, I couldn't join.
Okay.
And I'm joining from a different user, actually, because in my phone is hanging, actually. So for that only, I joined from my auntie's phone.
Okay.
And okay.
What's your name, you said?
My name is Shubho. S-U-B-H. Shubho Nandi. N-N-D-Y. Yesterday I've texted you in the night.
Yeah. Right. Correct. I remember now. Mr. Sanjay Bankura. Shailendra Srivastav. Dusri baar aap attend kar rahe ho. पिछले लास्ट वीक भी अटेंड किया आपने. ठीक है, रिफ्रेशिंग हो जाएगा, नो प्रॉब्लम. संजय बनकुरा.
जी सर.
सो हाउ आर यू मिस्टर संजय बनकुरा, कहाँ से हो आप?
जी सर, फरीदाबाद से. एकदम बढ़िया, आप बताओ.
फरीदाबाद.
जी सर.
तो आप कल अटेंड किए थे?
नहीं सर, मेरा फर्स्ट टाइम
है. ये फर्स्ट टाइम है? अच्छा
जी.
तो कल का रिकॉर्डिंग देखा आपने?
सर मेरी आज ही बात हुई थी एक्चुअली, तो मैंने अभी ज्वाइन करा है.
ठीक है, मैं आपको एक लिंक देता हूँ, आप नोट कर लीजिए. इसके बाद आप जाके वो वॉच कीजिए, क्योंकि उसमें मैंने कल ये बताया कि 85% रियल एस्टेट एजेंट्स लोग क्यों फेल होते हैं, तो वो जानना जरूरी है ना.
जी बिल्कुल.
फेल क्यों होते हैं, तो सक्सेस क्यों नहीं होते, फेल क्यों होते हैं? तो फेल का कारण, फेल्यूर का कारण जो है वो मैंने कल बताया था. उसमें आप जाके तो यूट्यूब में जाके देख लीजिए. मैं आपको लिंक दे देता हूँ, आप नोट कर लीजिए.
हेलो
हेलो
जी सर
आ रहा आ रहा
ठीक है ओके
एक मिनट अंदर आए थे डोर क्लोज नहीं है So, all right, I'll just give you this link. Please note down this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, hi.
Look also, my good.
HTTPS colon double slash remax remax में बीच में एक dot आएगा rem.ax YouTube Sridhar
ओके सर
ओके
जी जी
बिल्कुल ओके Three simple rules in life. तक लोग आएंगे ना तब तक हम ये देखते ये थोड़ा देखेंगे और समझेंगे Three simple rules ये होता है कि if you don't go after what you want, you will never have it. अगर आपको कुछ चीजें के जरूरत है
जी
तो उसके पीछे तो जाना पड़ेगा मतलब वो विश करना पड़ेगा तब आपको मिलने का चांसेस है इफ यू डोंट आस्क द आंसर इफ यू डोंट आस्क द आंसर इज ऑलवेज नो इफ यू डोंट स्टेप फॉरवर्ड यू आर ऑलवेज इन द सेम प्लेस Just close the door.
Network issue again, sir. Kuch.
Okay. Mute कर दूँ सबको?
हाँ कोई दिक्कत नहीं okay.
Okay. 11:33 हो गया है. फिर भी लोग थोड़ा टाइम ले रहे हैं आने के लिए Thirty-two, thirty-three. Thirty-three people are there. 34. Shall I wait for another 2-3 minutes? 11:36. We will start. थोड़ा odd time. 11:35 नहीं, 11:40 नहीं. 11:36 को स्टार्ट करेंगे सो वी हैव अबाउट 34 पीपल डिसेंट ऑडियंस है सो अमन मिटल इज सेइंग लेट्स स्टार्ट वंडरफुल वंडरफुल ठीक है जस्ट वन मोर मिनट वन और टू मिनट्स वन मोर मिनट But couple of people are not able to still connect to the audio. That is the issue. I'm seeing that yesterday a lot of people in the WhatsApp messages I have received and my team also has received that they have not been able to connect. Maybe it is their first experience or something like that. But if it is a first experience, it is desirable that they should immediately find a way of how to join in Zoom, because Zoom is the most prominent and very famous video conference tool. So people are opting for Zoom. Now I think slowly other things are coming. Google Meet is coming, Jio Meet is coming, and slowly it is coming. But it will take some time for people to pick up that. But till then, I think we should all get to know how to join Zoom. And don't think that Zoom is a Chinese app. It is not a Chinese app. It is the founder of that Zoom. He is a Chinese person. But settled in US. Right from the time he was born. He is there in that place only. Okay, but he discovered this and that is why. So questions have started coming in. Yeah, we do have in Bhubaneswar, but I would suggest that you get attached to Kolkata office. Bhubaneswar, you can get attached to Kolkata. Now we are all going to be digital only. We will not be meeting here only. So online only. So you can get attached to Kolkata. Okay, let's begin. Okay, so let me mute everyone and then I'll start it. I'll just take a second in that. I'll mute everyone and stop allowing the participants to unmute themselves. Okay, warm welcome to all of you. And today I would like to understand, there are quite a few people who are first timers. So I would like to understand how many such first timers have come. So I'm going to launch one small poll here. Just please answer this. Okay. How many of you are first timers today? Yeah, please click that. I know that you are saying I am, but you can just mention there also. How many of you are first timers today? Okay, out of this present group, I have got 61% who are repeats and 11% are first timers. So good. The 61% people are really serious people. I'm sharing the results for you. So here is the result for you. 61% people are repeats and 39% are first timers today. Okay, for the benefit of a quick recap for the first timers, I will tell you that yesterday, we discussed mainly on two things. One is why 85% of the real estate agents fail. Let me share the screen. So we discussed why 85% of the real estate agents fail. And I won't be able to repeat that today because again it will take another 1 hour session. Then the main point that I wanted to discuss today will not be able to discuss. So therefore, please, what you do is, those who are attending for the first time today, you can go to my YouTube channel. This is my YouTube channel, https rem.ax/YouTube Sridhar. So let me type if you want. I can show you typing it out. It is https://remax.ax/YouTube Sridhar. If you go to this channel, you will get the you will get your yesterday's session. These calls are some people who are trying to say that I'm not able to log in and all that. So, sorry, I cannot attend. This is the link. Kindly note down this. So if you have noted down this, we'll move on. Okay. So today what we'll do, we'll discuss about how do we find genuine clients? How do you find, in fact, buyers? So this is a big problem, because inventories are available anyway. Inventories are plenty available in the market. And what you need to do is to find buyers for that. How do we find them? So this is a big challenge for most of us. So let's try to understand. Okay, from this understanding, you will also discover that we're all, you know, we have gone wrong earlier. So I'm opening up this slide for you. Okay, so from where do we get buyers? I'll come to that. But before that, we'll find out the genuine client finding strategy. How do we discover that the client who is calling you for seeing the property, how do we find that he is genuine or not? So you need to meet him before site visit. So first thing what you do, supposing you get a call saying that you have advertised the property and there is a person who has shown interest in seeing the property. So he wants more details about the property. So what he does, he calls you or he messages you. Always try and see that, you know, the customer calls you, because when you start calling him, supposing you have seen the, he has seen the advertisement and he has shown interest in the computer, whether, you know, if you have posted in 99 Acres or if you have posted in Magic Bricks or if you have posted in any of the online portals, and then somebody has seen that and said that, yes, I'm interested in this property. It could be that he would have been just exploring. There is a possibility, and by mistake, he might have given details. Or sometimes some of the portals, what they do is, even if they go and see the property, I mean, see the property advertisement, they will immediately capture that. The portals will immediately capture the name of the person, mobile number, email ID and all that, and then gives you as a lead. Okay, actually he may not be serious. So that could be a possibility. So what happens when you start calling him, the other side, in case he is not a serious customer, he will start playing around with you. He will start asking many questions to you. Kaam padta hai? Where is the property available? Location kidhar hai? And even what is the price? Kahan dekha tha? Haan, dekha hoga shayad. So all these kind of replies will come and he will put you totally into a defense situation where you will feel you will get into a shell and start answering him all the questions that he is asking you. How will it be if it is the other way around? Supposing he asks you, he calls you, right? He makes a call to you. Then what do? You will start asking him questions. Sir, aapka requirement kya hai? Okay, kya hai budget aapka? So you will start asking him questions. So this is the position that you should be in. As a real estate agent, you should be in a position to ask questions to the buyer and find out his actual requirement. If you are in that position, definitely there is a chance that the transaction will materialize in a most promising manner and positive results will come. So how do you find the genuine customer? Assuming that somebody calls you at that time. Even if you are watching on WhatsApp in your mobile and you have no job to do, you have nothing, you are probably having a cup of tea or you are watching a TV or you are watching WhatsApp, some unforeseen work that you are doing, even then you must present to him as if you are very busy. So you need to tell him always one answer, one reply you should give him. So thank you very much for calling. Please don't mind, sir. I'll give you a call in about half an hour's time. I'm right now in front of a customer. As soon as I finish this customer meeting, I'll definitely call you. So if you think that, is it a lie? It is a white lie. It is a white lie. White lie which does not harm anybody is okay for that. You can always tell because it is not going to harm him. So why do you say this? What is the reason? I want you to gain about half an hour's time for you to understand the profile of this person. How do you understand the profile of this person? His number would have come, right? He would have told you his name. I'm so-and-so, I'm calling from so-and-so. I mean, I saw your advertisement, that is why I'm calling you. He might have told you this. Then that number and the name, all that you need to do is go to Google, okay? Put his name and number. And you will get a series of same person's name and number and same person's name, plenty, but wherever the number matches, you will get either a Facebook profile or a LinkedIn profile of that person. 98% you will get that. Only 2% chances you may not get, okay? 98%. So when you go to his Facebook profile, you will be able to discover what sort of a person he is. What is his background? Right? Is he an IT employee? Is he a businessman? Is he an agent? All this category of differentiation, you will get to know about it. So once you know that what is the profile of this person, then you know if he is from an IT background, right? Within half an hour, you call him back. So you call him back and tell him, sir, I'm sorry, I could not attend to your call at that time. Now that I have, I'm free from all these things, sir, I can spend any amount of time for you. You were asking about the property. Right, sir. So I'll give you the property details. This is so-and-so, so-and-so, so-and-so. This is the property details. And then ask him, I'm not sure whether this is going to match your requirement. Could you please tell me what is your requirement? And then ask him questions. Ask questions like, you need to find out his exact requirement over the phone. Then you tell him that, I think, sir, as you are asking questions, he's going to tell you, sir, the number of questions that I have is too many. What I would suggest is that, can we meet up? Can we meet personally? Or can we meet on Zoom? Try and see whether you can meet him on Zoom. Okay, if you can save time on going and personally meeting him. So earlier days, I was recommending that you should go and meet him personally, either at his place or he should come to your office. But now, because of the current pandemic situation, I recommend that you insist on a Zoom meeting with him. So ask for the Zoom meeting, and then in the Zoom meeting, get into more details of asking him about his requirement. And say that, sir, I have matching your requirement. I have 10 to 15 properties available with you, sir. So my recommendation to you would be that I will expose this property first online to you. Have a look at these properties and shortlist any one or two, and I'll give you a detailed presentation about this. Is that okay with you? Then he will say, yes, no, right? If he says, if he's avoiding meeting, if he's not willing to meet you in advance, kya dekhna hai, you just give me the details, I'll come and visit the property and see and all that, right? Then please be sure that, he might probably not be a serious customer. He's wanting to explore. You need to avoid showing him the property till such time you are sure about what is his background and whether he is really serious about it. the seriousness you will come to know only by meeting that person. And when you are asking questions, you'll be having a list of inventories with you. And you should say, supposing I take you to the site visit and show you, would you be able to take a decision of buying the property now? So he might say, no, I'm not ready now. I'm actually planning to buy this in the month of February. Okay, we are in August now. If he says that I'm in the process of buying the property only in the month of February, there is enough time for him to think of buying that. Then you can tell him, sir, in that case, there is no point in seeing the property now. Okay, what do we do is, we do one thing, around November, December, I'll get in touch with you. So that time we will discuss, and then I would have got some more new properties would have come to me. At that point of time, I will show you that. So you are avoiding. Why do you want to avoid showing the property? Sir, hamara kaam wahi hai na. Property dikhane mein kya problem hai? Nahin. So that is what is a question that you might be having. Nahin. Property is something like gold. What is real estate? Real estate is nothing but information sharing. Information. In the real estate industry, the most vital part of the game is information. If somebody comes to know that this so-and-so property is available for sale, right? That is an information. And that information can be misused by people in any form, any way. So you need to avoid showing the property till such time you are very sure about this customer that he is a serious customer. It doesn't mean that he comes to see the property and immediately he will purchase. No, no need. But at least you know that he is a serious customer. You can show him some 2-3 options, and then in 2-3 options, he should be in a position to finalize. You need such customers. So to find out that customers, you need to do a lot of homework. Okay, the homework is what is very crucial for you. So homework ke baad, agar if I have to tell you, you know, there is a difference between hardworking and smart working. Hard working and smart working is, hard workers are there, very, very many hard workers are there. Are all hard working people are able to see big money? No. Right? You see people who are cutting the stones, right? There are hard working people. People who are doing welding jobs. There are hard working people, welding jobs, right? So many such jobs are there where hard working, mother, homemaker, they are all hard workers. Because they, from morning till evening, they'll be in the kitchen doing things for us, for all of us. Hardworking people. Individually, if you see, do they make big money? No. They don't make. They don't make money. In real estate industry also, you know, there is a difference between hardworking and smart working. Hardworking, subah se shaam tak, you keep showing properties, properties, properties after properties after properties, or go and keep on seeing properties. These are all hardworking. Effort with no result. So if result has to come, there must be 50% of the time that you need to devote time only in planning, and the balance 50% is the execution part. Do you know the story about the tall man and the short man? So let me tell you the story and then come back to this, the story for some people who actually want to understand the meaning of the smart working part. Okay, the tall man joins a timber yard where there is a short man who keeps cutting the tree with about 1 or 2 hits of the axe. And this tall man thinks that I can cut more wood than him. And he tries to do that, but end of the day, he sees that the short man is able to cut more wood than the tall man. So the tall man feels that, okay, I should cut more wood than him because he is too short a guy. How do I make sure that I cut more wood? So the next day, he decides to come 1 hour early. And he comes 1 hour early and starts cutting the wood. End of the day, same result. This guy comes only at about 10 o'clock. By 5 o'clock, he winds up. But he has been able to cut more wood than the tall man. The next day, he comes 2 hours early. He skips his food, lunch, breakfast, everything. He doesn't go for tea break and other things. He wants to cut more wood than the short man. End result, same result. Okay, the short man has been able to cut more wood. Then fourth day he goes and asks him, Baba, tell me, what is that magic that you have that you are able to cut more wood than me? I'm seeing you are only 4 feet height, but I am 6.5 feet height, but I'm still not able to cut more wood than you. Can you give me the secret of this power that you are holding? So this guy says, all that I do is I spend half a day in sharpening the axe. You got it? Axe is the one which is cutting the wood, right? He spends half a day in sharpening the axe. So similarly, in real estate, you need to spend more time in planning, less time in execution. More time in planning is what? More time the planning, researching, and these things, you need to spend a lot of time. And then you get into execution part of it. Then your strike rate will be very high. You will be actually, you know, meeting about probably about 3 people or 4 people in a month, right? But out of 3 or 4 people that you're meeting, 2 to 3 people will close the deal. Instead of seeing 50 people, but you need to have that 50 or 100 people in hand because it's a number game. Out of the 50 or 100 customer leads, 3 or 4 will keep closing every month. But for that, you need to spend a lot of time in doing that homework. So how many of you knew that you can find the profile of the person by just going to Google? Okay, was it a good takeaway today? Key takeaway today? For you to find the profile of the person? Whoever is calling you? Yes, no. Admin says, yep. Thomas says, yep. Oh, that's all, only 2 people out of 44. Mihir Srinivas says yes. Were you doing all these things in the past? Yes, no. Were you doing this? No. So now do you know the secret of finding out the genuineness of the customer? Now when you go through the profile, will you not come to know whether he is an agent or whether he is really capable of buying or not from his profile? So that is the secret. We do this day in and day out. That's why, you know, we meet less people. We have huge number of leads in our hand, but we meet very less people. And whomever we are meeting, most of the time the closure takes place. This is precisely what I want to teach you people, that this is what you need to do. Okay, we'll move on to the next secret. Just a second, it's loading. So meeting him before visit is important. The next point is ensuring brokerage form signature. If you are showing the second sale property, you need to get this brokerage form signed by him. Of course, it is not required for a new property because in new property, you're not going to ask for any brokerage from the buyer. But when it comes to second sales, you have the right to ask brokerage from this buyer and also from the seller. But this brokerage form has to be signed. How often you will find that if at all you are using this or you are messaging him and asking him to confirm, you know, that you will be paying brokerage, 6 out of 10 people will not give you signature. 6 out of 10 people will not send you a message back saying that I confirm that I'll pay you brokerage. So why do they do that? They don't want to pay you brokerage. That is why they don't want to give you any commitment on the brokerage payment. Those who are not willing to give you brokerage payment, commitment in the form of either a brokerage form or by WhatsApp or by email, it means that they are not very serious. And if at all you continue to go and start serving him, you will end up not getting any brokerage from the person. This is a very serious threat in this industry. In this industry, it is very, very difficult to pull out brokerage because nobody wants to pay brokerage. Nobody wants to pay brokerage to anybody. They don't want because that is, they feel that kaam kya kiya hai apne. खाली एक प्रॉपर्टी दिखाया बट बाकी सब प्रॉपर्टी किसी और का खरीदना किसी और को राइट बीच में आप घुस के व्हाई डू यू वांट टू अर्न मनी दिस इज देयर थिंकिंग बट द इंडस्ट्री इज देयर इंडस्ट्री इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन द ब्रोकर्स एवरी इंडस्ट्री हैज गॉट एवरी प्रोडक्ट हैज गॉट ब्रोकर्स कमीशन एजेंट्स वी आर ऑल कमीशन एजेंट्स सो इवन एफएमसीजी प्रोडक्ट्स which is being sold in the market, right? In a retail shop, who are they? They are commission agents, they are brokers. Aap jaake khareed rahe na, provisions wagera wo sab. They're all brokers only. They are not actually, you know, you can't say that this, everybody is a commission agent. Who is not a commission agent? The person who manufactures himself and sells the product himself, he is not a commission agent. Everybody else is a commission agent. So there is nothing wrong in becoming a broker. Broker is a very good profession. But can you please close the door? I'm getting a lot of disturbance. Okay, so, but point is, they fail to pay. They don't want to pay. Nobody likes to pay this money. Commission, kyun payment karna? That is why you need to be very, very serious, very, very careful in trying to ensure that you deal with the right kind of people. So the right kind of people are who? The one who agrees to sign and give you a commitment saying that, yes, I'm willing to pay you your brokerage. The right kind of people are those who are willing to send back a message, who replies to your phone calls, who responds to your phone calls, who replies to your mail, who replies to your WhatsApp messages. These are the people who are actually serious about it. And you tell them to call on some specific time. You tell them that, okay, I'm arranging a site visit for you on so-and-so time. And you please come over. Those are the people actually who are really serious about it. So you need to find these kind of people and deal with them. Okay. So you will get less number of people accepting this. It's okay. Work for those people who are actually giving you a confirmation. So how many of you have actually done service and not earned brokerage? Can I have this thing, sir? If you have done service, you have provided service, but you have not been able to get brokerage. Okay, you just say me. Say me, me, me. Me, me means, it means that you have done service, but you have not got brokerage. I want to see how many such people are there. You got 2 people so far. So which means other people, oh my God, number is now increasing. So all of you have not been able to get the brokerage because you did not follow this procedure. You did not follow this procedure of taking the confirmation from the buyer or the seller. So that is why it is happening. So if you go ahead and start getting this brokerage form signed up and getting a confirmation in WhatsApp, getting a confirmation in email, so how good it could be. Just imagine, in the rental deals, this is very common. In the rental deal, hota kya hai? You will show a property to a tenant, टेनेंट विल ओवर द फोन सेज ओके आई विल पे यू ब्रोकरेज. वहां जाके दिखाने के बाद ही विल गिव यू रीजन एज टू व्हाई ही इज नॉट प्रोबेबली यू नो इंटरेस्टेड इन गोइंग एंड ही विल से ही विल गिव रीजन लाइक वास्तु लोकेशन ठीक नहीं है, बिल्डिंग ठीक नहीं है, और थोड़ा प्रॉपर्टी दिखा दो, राइट. ही विल से ऑल दिस थिंग्स एंड ही विल मेक यू गेट फ्रस्ट्रेटेड. ओके, एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द पीपल हु सी द प्रॉपर्टीज विल से दे आर नॉट इंटरेस्टेड. डोंट बिलीव, दे आर डेफिनेटली इंटरेस्टेड बट दे डोंट वॉन्ट टू पे यू ब्रोकरेज. So they will say that they are not interested. Now that they have not, they are aware of the property now, okay, backdoor mein jaate hain. So they will go backdoor, have a direct dealing with the owner or the seller, and then they have one understanding and they move in. After moving in, maybe after 2 months, 3 months, right, you will come to know that this is the property I showed this property to this person. He has come and occupied this place. By chance, आपको पता चल जाएगा. तो what will happen? You go and ask them, sir, मैंने दिखाया आपको. नहीं नहीं नहीं, मैं आपके through मैं नहीं आया. मैं आपके through नहीं आया. किसी और ने दिखाया था. मुझे कुछ अच्छा price मिल गया. So I have taken. You are not the person who's in. I don't know you. मैंने देखा भी नहीं है आपको. या शायद हो सकता है एक दो property आप दिखाया होगा. मुझे याद नहीं है. Standard replies from these people. Have you experienced this? Have you all experienced this? Yes. Most of the people have experienced this about the brokerage firm format. Don't worry, Thomas. Brokerage firm format and all is there. It's available. I'll share with you in the group. Okay. Don't worry about that. It's all there. So I'm seeing so many, yes, so many people have been duped in the marketplace. For your hard work, right? Where did you go wrong? You went wrong because you have not taken confirmation from him. You know, what do? We have got three formats. One, we take client registration form. Then the client registration form, we clearly write down what is the client name, address, where does he stay and all that. And then what is his exact requirement? And finally, we get his signature. Okay, saying that I confirm that I will be paying 1% or 2% plus GST for your services. He signs and gives us a form. After that, we don't stop there. What do? We take a copy of that, scan a copy of that. We send a mail to him saying that this is in reference to our discussion. So a copy of this is being given to you. This is for your information. So there is a record which is available in case the brokerage form is lost in the office. At least you have a mail which will remain in your mailbox for as long as you want. So this is one security that you have. The next one that we do is whenever we are showing a property to the person, there is something called site visit form. So in the site visit form, property address will be there. Property feedback options will be given to him. Yes, I am interested. No, I am not interested. I would like to see more properties, etc., etc. Some 4-5 options will be there, which he has to tick and sign the property in the site visit form. I will show, let us say, we are showing about 5 properties to one individual. I will have 1 brokerage confirmation form and 5 site visit forms from him. Okay, so all this is signed by him. Now, what happens when this signed document is available with you and then he doesn't pay you brokerage? What will you do? Simply go and tell him that, look, I have got documents. I need my brokerage. For the hard work that I have done, I deserve my brokerage. Please give me. If you don't give me, I'm going to go legal. Now, ek lawyer notice bhej do. Chup chap office mein aake aapko check de dega. Provided you have all these documents. Now, you don't have any documents of this. No site visit form. No client registration form. You go to a lawyer. Lawyer will say, I will not even take your case because there is no proof. Court will believe only in documentation. You don't have any proof that you have shown him property. You don't have any proof that he has agreed for brokerage. So how can I file a case? Lawyer will not even send him a legal notice. But if you have this document, even if it is in a white sheet of paper and you have a signature, it is valid in the court of law. You can always send him a note. One notice goes to him he will come to your office and give you your check. But ek karna hai. Like, will you start practicing this from today? Don't worry, I will share brokerage form format, site visit form format, everything in the group I will be sharing. Do not worry about it. Okay? Will you follow from today? Right. Good. Next point, which is very, very important for you to close the deal, is you need to ensure that the family comes with the person. He comes alone, right? More or less, he will not be able to decide on that. We will try to, but then implementing the same is difficult. Anirban Basu, you are saying, not at all. It is in your mind, sir. Sir, let me see, in my office, my team, I have got a 30-member team. Not a single person will do business with anyone who is not willing to give a confirmation. Not a single person in my team will do that. Everybody will do only if the other person agrees to sign the document. Okay, so it is in your mind. Why do you want to do a service where you are not secured of the money? You want money or not? Charity kar rahe ho kya? Nahi na. So if you want money, then you do business in your terms. When you go to a shop, is the shop owner not putting his terms? He said, aap baithiye sir. This customer ko attend karke main aapko dekhta hoon. Please sit down. Aap nahi karte ho kya? You go to a saloon. Saloon mein haircut karne ke liye ja rahe ho na. Kya bolenge wo log? Reception mein chair mein baitho bol rahe hain. Hai ki nahi? Bolenge ki nahi? What do you do? Chup-chap baithenge na. When he is ready to cut your hair only, then you can go. Similarly, when in real estate business, if he is ready to follow my terms and condition, only then I will do business with him. Otherwise, no. Kyun karna hai? WhatsApp confirmation counts. Yes, it counts. Please remove this, no? This scratching, whoever is doing, please remove that. Kindly remove this. Please don't play around in my screen. Okay? Whoever has done it, please remove this. Okay, WhatsApp confirmation is there, but try and get, even if WhatsApp confirmation is there, when you meet him personally, this format is required. You have to be very polite in telling him. Aise bolenge to wo sign karke nahi denge. Sir, ye form hai, thoda signature karke de dijiye. If you tell like this, he will not sign. You know, the power of our team is, our team says, there are a lot of people who will say no, no, no only. No, kyun? मेरे बात पे भरोसा नहीं है क्या? ट्रस्ट नहीं है क्या? अगर ट्रस्ट नहीं है तो वो बिल्डर बोलता है कि ट्रस्ट नहीं है क्या? ओके, कैन ही गिव द प्रॉपर्टी विदाउट एनी डॉक्यूमेंटेशन? सेल डीड नहीं चाहिए सर, ट्रस्ट करो ना सर बायर को, वो आपको पेमेंट दे देगा, आप उनको प्रॉपर्टी दे दो ना, करेगा क्या वो? नहीं नहीं नहीं, अग्रीमेंट साइन करो बोलेगा, है कि नहीं? सेल डीड साइन करो बोलेगा, रजिस्ट्रेशन करना है बोलेगा, है कि नहीं? वो सब ठीक है क्या उन लोगों के लिए? तो हम लोग कौन है? फॉर अस व्हाट इज द प्रॉब्लम? बिकॉज यू टेक इट लाइटली, यू टेक योर बिजनेस वेरी लाइटली, यू थिंक दैट माय बिजनेस मैं ऐसे ही करूंगा. ऐसे ही करने से आप डेफिनेटली फेल हो जाएंगे. यू विल डू वर्क बट यू विल नॉट गेट योर ब्रोकरेज. व्हाट्स द पॉइंट? हाउ डू वी इंश्योर फैमिली टू कम फॉर द साइट विजिट? इसका भी एक तरीका है, बोलना पड़ेगा कि इफ इट इज पॉसिबल इन सेकेंड सेल्स, इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल इन फर्स्ट सेल, बिकॉज प्रॉपर्टी इन्वेंटरी तो बहुत रहेगा डेवलपर के पास. बट सेकेंड सेल में आपको ये करना है कि यू ब्रिंग द फैमिली, बिकॉज यू नीड टू सी, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू द सिंगल पर्सन टू टेक अ डिसीजन अबाउट दिस, फैमिली विल बी देयर, सो प्लीज कम अलॉन्ग विद द फैमिली. इफ द फैमिली कम्स, दैट मीन्स ही इज रियली अ सेकेंड सेल, करेक्ट? In the secondary property, I'm talking about secondary market. Okay, not in the primary market. Primary market also, if he comes very nice along with the family, but there you cannot insist on the family to come. Now, because inventories are very high, and moreover, there we are not taking from buyer brokerage also. But in the secondary sale, you need to ensure that the family comes. When the family comes, even if the man, okay, doesn't want to pay brokerage, the wife will tell, ये मत करना, उन्होंने काम किया है, उसका जो पैसा है वो देना पड़ेगा. सो द वाइफ विल एक्चुअली कोक्स द हस्बैंड टू मेक द पेमेंट टू द ब्रोकर इवन इफ ही डजंट वांट टू पे. सो दैट इज द पावर ऑफ फैमिली. सो यू नीड टू एंश्योर दैट द फैमिली कम्स. If you do all these things, the decision-making process time will be very quick. So instead of showing the property to the person, and waiting for the decision to be taken by him later on, where you will wait for months together, is that better? Or you do all the job prior to making the site visit, and then once the site visit is happening, within a month or two, he should be in a position to take a decision. Which is better in this? To ensure business success, the second option which I told you is the only one. That is the secret mantra of this business. This is the secret of being successful in this business. Do you all agree? Do you all agree? Okay. So now that the basics of, you have understood two important points in this business. One, you should not start your business if you do not have enough inventories in hand. You have understood that yesterday. You will not show the property to a person who is not serious. This is the second secret that you have understood, right? Now with these two things you have understood and you have trained yourself now, and you will change. You will start seeing success. Now to become more successful, now there is one more skill that you have to develop. The skill. What is that skill? That skill is to become digital. I'm seeing half the people here, Gurvinder Singh, Neelam Sharma, Rajesh Khanna, three people have not been able to connect to their audio still. Either they have switched off the audio button in the beginning when they are coming, so they are not able to connect. Okay. Or they don't know. You see, they have dropped off also. Why? Because they don't know. This is a skill. Getting connected in Zoom also is a skill. You need to know about it. Now you have to become digital. Yesterday I showed you some examples of people who are earning millions and crores of money in online world. Now online world is a different world altogether. You also can earn big money here, provided you upgrade your skill. You need to upgrade your skill. So how do we upgrade the skill? Independently, do you think you can do it? Go and learn something and then do business on your own? Impossible. You need to be associated with successful people. Who are the successful people? The people who are all here. Supposing we all join together and almost every second day we meet each other, right? We meet each other every second day. We meet each other for about, let's say, half an hour, 1 hour, and then try to learn. I take up the role of a mentor, right? If I take up the role of a mentor, I guide you, right, in every step of yours. Do you think you will be able to see success? Or do you think independently when you go after the training program is over, today I finish the program, tomorrow I conduct one more program and then we complete and we don't meet each other. Okay. After that you go and start doing business on your own from whatever teachings that I have given you, right? Independently, all alone, will you be able to do business still even after learning this? Yes, no, tell me. How many of you feel that there is a guide who is required? There is a mentor who is required for you to see success in life. Guide is required, right? Skill is required. If you are in a group of people who are very successful, nobody can stop you from succeeding. Mentor is required every time in our life. mentor and skills required. Yes, both are required. Everybody is saying this. Now, I'll tell you what are the skills that you need to learn. Yesterday, I've talked about email automation. I've talked about chatbot, messenger chatbot, which is required. Now, today, I'm going to show you something different. You see? Let's try and see what is the difference. Before that, I want to understand, I want you to tell me how many of you are aware of RE/MAX. I'm just now putting this poll to understand whether people are aware of RE/MAX or not. Okay. Just say that, yes, I am aware. No, I have not heard of this name. Percent of people have voted now, 40% have still not voted. All right, I'll just take another 10 seconds and I'll stop the poll. Done. Okay. I'm sharing the results for you. You can see in this result that 38% of the people in this group are not aware of RE/MAX. 62% of the people are aware of RE/MAX. But these 38%, they deserve to know what is RE/MAX all about. But I will not show them presentation about RE/MAX and all those things. I'll quickly give a snapshot so that we have got other things to attend to. If I get into who is RE/MAX, when was it started, who is the founder, how many offices are there, those things if I get into, it will take 1 hour. So I will not get into that. I will briefly tell you in one single slide. Okay. In fact, extempo I will tell you. I will not even show you the slide. See, RE/MAX is an internationally well-known real estate broking firm, started in the year 1973 in US. We are the largest real estate broking firm. We are the largest real estate sellers in the whole world. When you are saying we are the largest, I am not saying we are one of the largest. We are the largest. I'll give you an example as to why I'm saying this, we are the largest. RE/MAX has got 8,000 offices in about 118 countries. RE/MAX has got 1,35,000 agents who are associated with RE/MAX. On an average, one agent sells 17 properties in one single year. On an average. When I say that average, there is a difference between one person doing 50 sales and another person doing zero sales. This is also available in this, you know, RE/MAX agents. But on an average, 17 sales are happening. Multiply that into 1,35,000 agents. So how much? It comes to close to around 22 lakh property sales in a single year. 22 lakh properties in a single year means what? Every 30 second or every 45 second, you can see in this whole world, somewhere at some place, at some location, you will find somebody is registering through RE/MAX agent. We can tell this in India and get away. There's no problem. Nobody will question us. But in countries like US, Canada, UK, and all that, you can't simply say and then get away. You have to prove by proof. If there is something wrong in that statement, you will be sued. The founder will go behind the bars. For the last 25 years, we are claiming that we are number one. this is such a big company. This is a brand. Okay. So when I say about brand, I want to ask you a question. Another poll, I'll just ask you this. Brand power. How many of you feel that brand support is a must? How many of you feel that not necessary, I can do business on my own? How many of you feel that I have no idea about what is this brand? Okay, this is the question, simple question that I'm asking you. Let's see that what you're saying. voted. I'm looking at some more, little more people saying something. Great, this is enough. 72% people have voted. So this is the result. The result is 88% of this group feel that brand support is a must. Very knowledgeable people, very knowledgeable crowd. This group is very knowledgeable. There is not a single person who is saying, not necessary, I can do business on my own, which means you have put down all your ego down and still you feel that, yes, I need to collaborate with some brand and do business. Very good. There are 13%, four people who are saying, I have no idea what is this brand all about. Don't worry. Those four people who are saying that you are in a confused state of mind, don't worry. As I'm going to show you some proof now, you'll be able to understand what is this brand all about. Okay. But still, for the benefit of those 13% people, I'm just telling you, supposing you want to buy a t-shirt today, right? Will you go to a branded showroom? Or will you go to a local shop and buy? You know that when you go to a branded showroom, you have to pay more price, right? It won't be available easily. Majority of the people today are moving towards brand consciousness. KFC, McDonald's. You know, when you go there, all these places, it's going to be expensive. Mac showroom. Okay, and now, even for cutting your hair, you prefer going to a branded saloon. You don't go to a local barber shop. Why? Awareness has been created to some such an extent that brand is very important. We are moving towards that trend. All the urban people I'm talking about. Now, don't take an example of a village and say that brand kahan hai sir? Yahan. Yahan toh brand hi nahi hai. Toh wahan ka baat kar nahi kar raha hoon. I am talking about the metros, the A category and the B category cities where brand is now very popular, very important for everyone. So the fact that 88% people are saying that brand awareness is a must, now you are getting associated with such a brand. We are the brand, Remax. I have been in the business of real estate for the last 18 years, but 1.5 years back, I decided that I will attach myself with a brand. I was doing independently. I had a team of people and all that. I was reasonably successful. There's no issue. But in spite of being successful, in spite of having a team of people, I did not feel that I should continue to do with my local brand, with my Sridhar's property brand. No. I wanted a brand like Remax. I invested around 20 lakhs for that investment. Me, Mr. Kullar, Mr. Anurodh Jalan, who is there in this group, all of us have invested this kind of money to take that brand. So why did we take this brand? Because systems are available readily. Everything is available readily. That is why this brand is required. Plus the kind of knowledge that I have given you, if this is also there in the form of training, almost every day, every second day, every third day, if you are getting training like this, why will you not be successful in this business? You know that the world's richest people, or what percentage of people are rich? 5%. only 5% people are rich. 95% people are in the middle class, or lower middle class, and down. Only 5% category. Okay, if you want to be in that 5% category, this is what you need to do. Now, let's move on to the digital world, how it is going to be. I hope you got some idea about a brand. So those people who did not understand, can I just get one quick answer from them who said that I have no idea about the brand? Can they say that now it is clear, brand ke bare mein? Can they say just, I will not put a poll, at least can you say, yes, I have now clear? Ah, it's a trust. Somebody has said it is a trust. Clear, very good. Thank you so much for that. Now see, today in the digital world, most of the buyers that who are coming are for you strangers. Okay, you don't know them. They see your advertisement and then they call you and all that. You don't know them. So you have to present yourself good to them, isn't it? Now imagine if you send him a card like this, visiting card like this. I want you to simply answer me that if such a visiting card, a link, if you send it by WhatsApp to a stranger, what kind of a reaction you think that you will get from him? What do you think he will feel about you when you send such a visiting card? Can anybody volunteer yourself? There is one person who says he will ignore. Okay. The percentage of converting. Good. We'll think if it is genuine. High impact. Okay, what else? Seems professional. Yeah, what else? Professional. Digital card, digital visiting card, impressive. Professional. Person reacts. He will react. He will respond. Good value. So, who said that he will ignore? That is Moto. Please, I'm sorry. I forgot your name. You logged in with somebody else's name. So, please understand now. What you said is your opinion. What the rest of the people said is the reality. Because if everybody says he will ignore, then my perception is wrong. If majority of them say that it is genuine and professional and the response is going to be very good, the reaction will be very good, the impression will be very good in the minds of the buyer, then that is what actually stays. Okay. So please change your opinion that it is definitely a professional and it will exhibit. Even if it doesn't click and view also, at some point of time when he wants to see that, he will definitely value you and he will think that you are from a professional company. Okay, that is the impression that you need to create. Oh, no, you mean to say, Ocha, you said that the video is fast, is it? Okay, if he's a serious, no, it's not fast. It is very simple. You can keep playing it around every now and then. Okay, now I want somebody to volunteer a photograph. And I want to show you that this can be created in maximum 3 minutes time. Anybody can volunteer sending photograph, I will create and show you that within 3 minutes, you can create this visiting card. Can anyone send the card, send the photograph? And after sending, please tell me that you have sent. Lakshman Mondal, right? Lakshman Mondal, you have said you will send it, right? You already sent it to me. My number is 855-301-5850. 855-301-5850. I want you to send this photograph. In the meantime, I will just open my tool. I'll show you the tool. Sent. Shailendra Srivastav says that he has already sent me. So I will use this. Shailendra Srivastav. Kahan aaya to nahi hai, Shailendra ji. Achha, kahan bheja aapne? Did you send it to 855-301? No, I have not received it. Let me see if you have sent it here. No, Shailendra ji, I have not received it. Let me check up. Sent again, okay. 9007, okay. It is showing that my phone is not connected. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so many people have sent. Sir, mask nahi chahiye, sir. Who is sent this mask? Without mask, send it to me, no? I think this is come. This is also come. Debashish Roy. Okay. So let's take this Debashish Roy. As an example, I have downloaded this photo and now I'm going to the Max Center now. Mr. Rakesh ji, I'm just going to make you co-host. I want you to unmute Debashish Ray, okay, so that I can speak to him. I made you co-host, okay? You can unmute and then unmute this person also, Debashish Ray. Have you done that, Mr. Rakesh? Anurodh, I'm also making you co-host.
Yes, Sridharji, tell me.
Yeah, I just want you to unmute this gentleman by name Debashish Ray.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you can do that, because he has sent me the photograph, I'm going to create one visiting card for him. So I need his number and all that, right? Okay. So for that purpose, I need this. So these are the tools that we are going to get, something called Design Center. Design Center is there. And now I'm going to make a digital visiting card for him in less than 3 minutes. You please now watch the time. What is the time? Rakeshji, you please keep a timer and just see how much time I'm taking.
It's 12:40 now. Exactly.
Yeah. So let's see how much time we are taking. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Mr.
Debashish, 1, 2, 3, start.
Debashish Roy. Roy or Ray? So Debashish, can you tell me Roy or Ray?
Roy.
Correct, no?
Roy.
Correct.
Yeah.
Roy? Okay.
Correct.
ROY, correct. Okay. So, Remax, you will be in Calcutta, under Calcutta. So I'm going to put Remax property unlimited. Okay. Phone number. Can you tell me his phone number? Okay.
9051
88 2865. Okay, what's your email ID?
DEBASISH.
DEBASISH
29 385 385
@gmail.com. Okay. Website is https://remaxpropertyunlimited.gr8.com. Okay, this is what is the thing. And now I'm going to upload your photo.
Okay, let me add here that this mail ID is only for demonstration. If you join Remax, you'll get a Remax ID.
True. Yeah, this is only for demonstration purpose.
Yeah. Otherwise, it will be devashish@remax.in. That kind of mail ID you will get.
Correct.
Professional.
Okay. Done. What is the time now?
12:42. You've done it.
12:42, is it?
Yeah.
Okay. 2 minutes it has taken.
With the data entry, with the questions.
Yes. That's it. How does it look?
Great.
Let Mr. Debashish say. Debashish, how do you feel?
Yes. Great, sir. Great.
Anirban is saying, please play it again. I am getting excited. Okay. So let me play it again for him. Okay, good.
Just to add, this is one of the sample. It's just creation. So you will be getting a lot of other benefits with respect to technology.
Yeah, I'm just going to show him that also.
Yes. This is an awesome platform, Remax Center.
Okay, now this is one example that I've shown you. Now let me show you when it comes to property link sharing. When you have to share the link and all that, how do you share? Normally, what do? We send in WhatsApp, you know, all the images, one below the other, some 10, 12 images you will send it. You will send complete property details. And this will probably, you know, irritate the buyer because he doesn't want to get 12, 15 pages and which he has to keep on downloading that and then view that. He will really get irritated. He will not like it. Now, if you send him a different way of sending that same images in a different manner and in a very, very professional manner, Okay, how will it look? So let's see how it looks like. I'm going to show that to you now. Mr. Rakesh, I think somebody has unmuted. Kindly see that it is muted, so that we don't get any background noise or something. See, this is the property link which we can share it to a buyer, and here Debashish Rai's photograph can come. His name will come, his designation, his phone number, his email ID will come. Okay, by default, whoever is the business owner. In your case, if you are attached to Calcutta office, then Mr. Anurag Jalan's photo will be there by default. Okay, can you just give me this switch on? One minute, please. Ganges, just give me this wire, no, and switch on that. Battery is getting down. The charger. So you see how automatically it keeps moving. Isn't it? So now what happens? When you want to see the details of the property, all that you need to do is click here, details, and the details of the property is available here. You know, it gives you all the information like, I know, 3 BHK starting 2.14 CR, 4 BHK so much, and then close it. You want to share this, supposing he wants to share this to through email to his friend or to his wife. If somebody is in NRI and he wants to send it to somebody in India, then he can send it by email automatically like this only. Or he can post it in Facebook. He can send it by Twitter. Or he can just copy that link, okay, and just send it by WhatsApp. And he wants to contact. He just puts his name and email number and send. This message will come to Debashish Rai straight away. Automatically he will get it. Then he wants to see all the photographs in one screen itself. He can see, he can just click that and he can see all the photographs in one screen itself. And everything is available with simple link, that's all. This is the link. Now Debashish Rai, you have sent me photograph. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to send that this link to your WhatsApp right now. Okay, and you see how is it being presented in your mobile, how you can see this in mobile, how beautiful it will look like. I'm just sending now. So this is how it goes to him. See, this is thumbnail picture will be there, and then it goes. I've sent him some other property as an example. A thumbnail impression has come and then goes. Debashish Rai, have you received it?
Yeah, sir.
Just open it. How open and see how beautiful it looks like. Correct.
Yes, sir. V. Sridhar and Chandrasekhar, Business Association.
Yeah, correct. Of course, I have not put your photograph there. It is a different link. Digital visiting card is different.
Okay.
Different. Yeah?
It's okay, sir. It's okay. Yeah.
Yeah, this is just an example. But I want you to tell me, I want people to tell me that what kind of an impression you will create in the minds of the buyer when he receives like this. How will it look like? What will they say? What will they think about you? And about the property that you're getting. Are you going to get? Yeah, I'm sharing that.
Definitely.
Yeah. I've shared that link in the chat box also. Everybody can just click that and view in your respective mobiles. You see how beautiful it will look like. Okay, so we'll move on to the next thing. How this can be created? That I need to show you. Where will you create this? This you created now, visiting card. Now we have got something called design center. So this is the design center that we have. Okay. Now, what does it say? You see here, brochure. Supposing you have a second sale property, secondary market property. Okay, you got only photographs and all that. Now, you want to make a beautiful brochure of that. Okay, nice brochure, 2.5 crores worth. Resale property is available for sale. 2.5 crore requires a brochure kind of a material, right? It will look nice. So in that case, you can create brochure using this tool. Just click this and it will take you just about 3 minutes to create brochure. Okay, then you can make a newsletter if you want. You can make a flyer if you want. You can create a PPT, beautiful presentation using this tool, not the normal Microsoft PPT and all that. It's a very professional PowerPoint presentation you can do here. The link that I sent you was created using this tool called Virtual Tour. This is what I used it and I created that. You can create a website of your own. Okay, you can create a web advertisement. You can send a video email using this tool. So there is a plethora of options available for you in this tool. All can be done in just 2 to 3 minutes time. You got something called RE/MAX University. Okay, there are more than 700 video lessons which are available for you to learn from RE/MAX people. This is the kind of tool that we have. You will get access to that. You see here, watch a video. So you can just simply search and then keep going through these videos and all that. So it's an amazing tool that you have. Now I'll show you some example of how poster will be viewed, how poster will look like when you create a poster. See, how is it looking? It's asking for some email ID and all that. I have to log in. So let's not waste our time on that. But it's a beautiful poster that can be created. Okay. Then virtual property. Yeah, this you should see. Virtual property, how you can display.
For a video walkthrough of one of the projects which is under construction by the Shivalik Group. The Shivalik Group, which is one of the most reputed and the 2001, which is when brand Shivalik was formed. Hospitals like Krishna Shalby and clubs like O7 Club within 3 to 4 kilometers of the project. Shivalik Sharda Parkview 2 is a The kids' bedroom has good space for the kids with the planning of the study table as well, which doesn't have an attached bathroom but has a common. And the 60-day plan over here is set to save you more than 10 lakh rupees and is going to give you a return which is going to be double than your bank FD.
How professional is this? You see this virtual expo. You can go to hall number one. And these are all stalls. So each of these Eden Reality, Purti Reality, Imami Reality, Joy Ville, Orbit, they are all developers. You can go there and click to see what is the kind of property proposition that they are giving. You know, what kind of project. So you can go to hall number 2 and see these kind of properties which are available. So the buyer will get option of coming and picking and choosing what he wants to see in this virtual expo. This is a seminar hall, auditorium hall. So we get lounges like this, you know, Kolkata Digital Property Expo. We recently conducted last Sunday, we did this.
Now we have one going on in Pune.
Yeah, in Pune it is going on now.
Currently it is on.
Yes.
I have shared the link in the training group.
Yeah, right.
Somebody is interested in Pune properties, and soon we'll be planning for Bangalore and Delhi NCR. We'll be planning.
Okay. Now we have come almost to fag end of today's program, right? I will take a quick feedback from people as to what you felt about all seeing all these things now. Because today, tomorrow, one more day is there. Tomorrow, I'm going to talk about the mentorship program, you know, how you can benefit. And you see the kind of associates that who are currently associated with RE/MAX. What kind of lead generation that they have been able to generate. How quickly they have been able to close deals, right? All that. You know, I will show you tomorrow. But today, as of now, you have gone through 1.5 hours, right? We started at 11:30, now nearing 1 o'clock now. So 1.5 hours you've gone through. What are the key takeaways of today's learning? So you can put it in the chat box. I don't want any personal compliments. I'm not looking that you did well and all those things. No, I just want you to tell me what were you able to take home today, some message. What information you were able to take. It's good for business, really imperative and knowledgeable. Impressive and knowledgeable. Don't show the properties is a good takeaway for Anirban Boss. I feel like now I have more weapons in my arsenal. I will definitely protect the gold. I won't show property to everybody. The tools are very helpful and professional. Digitally Empower is a very important tool to do any business. Learning, experience and knowledge. Documentation is important part of business. Right. But how to get clients? Good points covered and interesting, good for knowledge. Okay, now I'm going to give you one small Google form. Okay. Just 1 second. I'm going to create one Google form and give you that link so that we have some useful information to be shared tomorrow. Yeah, I'm ready with the link. Just a second. Yeah. See, now what I'm doing is I'm going to send you one link, Google Form link. In that, what I want you to do is please submit one question that has been burning your present business. You know, you want to come out of that. You're not finding solution for that problem. Yesterday evening, I got a call from one person asking me, sir, when I'm dealing with a petrol pump business, you know, petrol pump, he wants to, he has identified a buyer and he encountered a lot of problems in dealing that petrol pump deal. Other brokers are coming, right? And there are some 7-8 brokers who are available in that petrol pump saying, you know, how to handle this kind of a situation. So he found it very difficult and he called me in the night yesterday and he told me, sir, I have this question, I have this problem. So how to solve this? He wanted to know that. So I told him, don't worry. In the training program, I will cover up all these things. So I will do this tomorrow. What I want you to do now is, I will be sharing that link with you like this. If you people are facing any problem, you need to submit your question, one single question. And tomorrow, first thing in the morning, I'll be answering all the questions of all the people. Supposing there are about 30, 40 people right now, all the 40 people that formats, Abhimanyu, don't worry, I'm going to post it in group. Okay, I'll be posting it in the real estate group. Are you all there in the chat group? Let me try to understand that. Are you all there in the chat group?
Yes, training no. Group.
Yes, no.
Yeah, I have a those, training group.
Those who are no, Abhimanyu Srivastav. Okay, now Anurojji, can you just share the link with me?
Okay, let's sure, me. Sure. I'll share the link. Yeah, you WhatsApp
the link. Yes. Rakeshji, can you share your link?
Yeah, yeah.
Share the link. And just I will also share Bangalore link and all that so that
yeah.
You can join there.
Yeah. Roger?
Okay, those who are in Kolkata, Anurodh Jalon will be posting the chat link. You join in that group. He has already posted that. So West Bengal can join in this group.
Delhi, I think someone from Digha is also here. Digha and
Digha, Digha also is okay. Fine. So Surat and all that, you know, Surat and rest of India can join in this group. Excepting Delhi, NCR, then Pune, Hyderabad, what other, Noida. Rakeshji, tell me, which are the locations of yours? Uttar Pradesh, you joined in the group that I posted just now. Okay, Delhi, NCR and all, wait, Rakeshji will post the group. You join in that group. Delhi people can join in the group. I think Rakeshji has got dropped off because he's not able to connect.
No, he's there.
But I think, I think I can take his link. So Delhi NCR people, please join in this group. He has already put it across. Correct. Rakesh has already
put it. I put the link now.
Rakeshji, whatever he has posted, that is Delhi group, Delhi NCR group. What I have posted is rest of India. What Anurodh Jalan has posted is West Bengal and Digha. Okay, please all of you join here. And I'll be posting the format for brokerage there is a client's registration form, property registration form, and site visit form. These three forms, I'll be posting it there. Okay. And remember one thing, use the Google form. Use the Google form and then submit your questions for me to answer tomorrow. Tomorrow will be the last day of the training session, but we will continue our relationship after that also. And I'll tell you some interesting offers that we have for in tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll tell you what kind of, how you can get associated with us and start working and start minting money. Okay. All right. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. All of you, thank you so much. The Google form is just now posted, Sheila. Just have a look.
Good day, gentlemen.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah, thank you, everyone. Okay, bye-bye. See you. See you tomorrow at 11:15. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, Ved Prakash. See you.